books. I am Dr. Sunil Gupta, Director in charge of the Allahabad Museum. The Allahabad Museum is one of the national museums of India under the Ministry of Culture. It has a very rich collection of ancient sculptures, paintings, terracottas, coins, and items of the freedom struggle, including the salt made at Dandi and the pistol used by our great freedom fighter Chandrasekhar Azad. As you know, we are passing through a hard time nowadays with the coronavirus lockdown, and I thought that why not we bring certain part of our beautiful collection before you. So this time, this is the first of the series, I chose the collection of the paintings of the Russian artist Nicholas Roerich for you. Nicholas Roerich was a very famous Russian artist, was born in St. Petersburg in 1874, and he died in India in 1947 in the lap of the Himalayas, which he loved so much to paint. When he died, after Roerich, he left behind a great legacy as a philosopher, an explorer, apart from being an artist. The Allahabad Museum has 19 works of Nicholas Roerich, which he gifted to the museum in the 30s, and two works of his equally illustrious son, Svetoslav Roerich. We also have some letters, a correspondence of Nicholas Roerich with our museum when the Roerich Hall was being set up, and I will show you at least one of these. So enjoy yourself with this presentation which is going to follow.
This is a portrait in oil of the great Russian artist Nicholas Roerich. And this painting and this portraiture has been done by his son Svetoslav Roerich, who incidentally was also a very famous painter and married to the Indian actress Devika Rani.
Now we move on to see some of the paintings of Nicholas Roerich himself, which are on display in the gallery of the Allahabad Museum. When the museum reopens, you will be able to see these paintings, but for now we bring them to you in this virtual presentation. This particular painting is called Arhat. You can see that the Arhat in Buddhist lore is a mendicant or a religious figure who has gone far in knowledge and enlightenment, and the creature that is approaching the Arhat obviously represents forces of negativity and evil, for which the meditation and prayer of the Arhat wards off the evil influences. As you know that Nicholas Roerich was in love with the Himalayas. He led expeditions into Tibet and Central Asia, and almost there are 4,000 paintings of Nicholas Roerich of the Himalayas, some of which we are going to show you ahead, but this one is more akin to the mountain Buddhism or Tibetan Buddhism that we find from Ladakh to Arunachal Pradesh. Of course, when I say that there are thousands of paintings, I quoted the figure 4,000 plus of Nicholas Roerich, I meant to say that these works of Nicholas Roerich on the beauty of the Himalayas are all not in the Allahabad Museum but spread all over the world. But we have a good collection of 5 or 6 paintings of Nicholas Roerich in his total collection of 19 paintings that we have, which are dedicated to the Himalayas, the beauty of the mountains as they forever change in the light of the day, of the evening, of the early morning. So enjoy yourself with these ones. Now, apart from his beautiful paintings of the Himalayan landscapes, the changing color of the mountains, which you just enjoyed, Nicholas Roerich also painted the mountains together with themes of spirituality. The Arhat painting is one which was like that. But what we have here for you is the painting where we see a sadhu lifting his hand towards the heavens, a rishi eternally striving for communion with the great heights. It is a work suffused with raw spirituality, capturing the moment of enlightenment. So this is a lovely painting that
the Allahabad Museum has in its collection.
This painting in the Allahabad Museum collection is titled Guga Chauhan and Narsingh. This is set in the beautiful Kulu Valley, which Nicholas Roerich made his home. This is in fact where he passed away, and his ashes were scattered in the mountains. This is where he started his Uruswati Research Institute, and his former home is now a beautiful museum dedicated to his paintings. And this painting reflects the local culture of the Kulu Valley. This painting by Nicholas Roerich is titled Dhyan Mudra. The painting depicts the figure of Buddha or a Bodhisattva carved into a rock face in the Himalayas. The Buddha figure is in meditating posture. This was possibly a local shrine which the artist chanced upon in course of his exploration of the Himalayas and Tibet. The painting appears to be a plain landscape work without any symbolism. This painting is titled Abode of Spirit. The painting depicts a stone sculpture in relief incised into a rock in the midst of the mountains. This is a typical shamanistic folklore deity of the Himalayan region. In all likelihood, Roerich had chanced upon this scene and was inspired to capture it on canvas. This work of Nicholas Roerich in the Allahabad Museum is titled Maitreya. The painting depicts a stark and lonely figure in the yellow, meditating in the midst of icy blue peaks. The great canopy of the sky is emphasized in the painting. The rather small figure actually seems to be exuding the strength of spirituality. The title of the work Maitreya is derived from the concept of the future Buddha who is yet to descend on earth. So, there is an almost apocalyptic quality to the work. This beautiful painting of Nicholas Roerich in the Allahabad Museum is titled Messenger of Shambhala. The picture shows the brilliant colors of a breaking dawn across a deep gorge. From the shadows, a man is preparing to shoot an arrow across the deep defile towards a monastery on the other side. The title of the painting, Messenger of Shambhala, suggests a Tibetan landscape where the legend of the great hero Shambhala lives on. The Roerich collection of Allahabad Museum is small but diverse. You would have enjoyed the series of paintings that we have of the beauty of the Himalayas, as well as paintings which have to do with the shamanistic deities and the mountain Buddhism and depiction of Tibetan Buddhism. And we also have paintings of Nicholas Roerich from some of his earlier phase, which I would call the Russian phase. These draw from his early years when he was painting in Russia before he left for Europe, America, and thence to India. This particular painting that you see is called She Who Leads. The painting shows lofty snow-capped mountains and the lone figure of a lady in robe leading a man through a precipitous path. This is one of Roerich's early works which draws from Russian folklore. This lovely painting of Nicholas Roerich in the Allahabad Museum is called The Holy Shepherd. The painting depicts the flute-playing figure of Lel, a folk hero of the ancient Slavonic tradition. With him are his two attendants. The scene is reminiscent of Lord Krishna of the Indic tradition, and the two attendants of Lel can be compared with the gopis of the Indian tradition. The painting depicts an idyllic sunset in which sheep graze peacefully. Nicholas Roerich was aware of the significance of his work and its similarity with the Krishna theme. This painting of Nicholas Roerich in the Allahabad Museum is right out of the church interiors. Its title is Light Penetrating Darkness, but could also be St. George slaying the dragon. It is a typical iconic depiction reminding us of Byzantine church interiors. The use of bright colors, bright yellow, red, green and black, infuse the work with a raw energy. This is one of Roerich's early works, drawing from Russian Orthodox Church tradition, a symbolic clash between the forces of good and evil. Another of Nicholas Roerich's fine works inspired by the Russian landscapes, this painting, titled Russian Church, depicts the first rosy light of dawn falling on the facade of a medieval Russian church with a typical blue dome and an architecture combining elements of the Orient and the Occident. This is the Grand Church at the old Russian capital of Novgorod.
This painting in the Allahabad Museum, titled Tibetan Monastery, is a work executed by Svetoslav Roerich, the illustrious son of Nicholas Roerich. As we have shown you earlier, right at the beginning, the other work that we have is the oil portrait of Nicholas Roerich done by Svetoslav. This painting shows a monastery in the half light of dawn, and has been, the style has completely followed that of his father Nicholas. We end the presentation by showing you a letter written by Nicholas Roerich to the authorities of the Allahabad Museum when the Allahabad Museum was under the municipality. This letter is dated 16th of February 1937, and it is also addressed to the Roerich Center of Art and Culture, which flourished in Allahabad in the 30s. This was the time when Nicholas Roerich had donated his paintings to the Allahabad Museum, and the Allahabad Museum has set up the Roerich Hall, which continues to be with us till date.